Hi there, this is Imaneo. Welcome to the third episode of building the Flappy Dash game. So as you know, we have started this series, and in this series we are implementing a game using Flutter and Flame game engine from scratch. So the game is called Flappy Dash, and it's just like Flappy Bird, but we switched the bird with the dash that we have. And if you haven't watched the previous videos, I highly suggest you to watch them because it's a series. And yeah, so in this episode we are going to take a look at the assets and the parallax effect for the background. So as you remember, here is the game that we are going to implement, and yeah, as you see, we have a player in the screen, and behind that we have some images or some trees, some clouds, and they are moving with different speeds based on how they close to us. And so the background effect is called Parallax effect, and we just want to add some layers of background and move them based on the distance that they have to us. And also we need to add the player sprite. So to do that, as you remember, this is the last state of the previous episode. So we are in part 2. I'm gonna create a new branch called part 3. And as you know, in each episode we will have a new branch, so you can compare the code with the previous episode. And yeah, so first of all we need to create a directory called assets, and inside that, as Flame suggests, we need to put the assets like this. So we can create audio, images and tiles directories inside the asset. And yeah, for example, our player can be inside the images, our background can be inside the images, and later we will have audios, and then we can put them inside the audio. And yeah, so using this structure, it is simpler to load the sprites or images. For example, here you just say that flame.images.load, and you don't need to put the path of the player because it is predefined in the Flame. So it's gonna be assets/images/player.png or enemy.png. So this is the convention that is provided by the Flame team, and we are gonna do the same. Yeah, let's create the images directory here. And yeah, so inside that I'm gonna bring our dash here. Yes. Yeah, this is the player. It is in a large size, so we don't care about the optimization at the moment. We just want to have a high quality game, and maybe in the further episodes we can define different assets for different screen sizes, so that's more efficient. But for now we just use the large image. And also, as you remember, for the background, yeah, so this is the dash that we are going to use. And for the background, as you remember, we have a layered background. So it is here. As you see, you can see the different layers of the background that we have. Yeah, so I just exported all of them, and I'm gonna put them inside the directory that we have. For example, I will create a directory called background. And now let's import the layers. So they are here. I'm gonna copy paste them here. Yeah, so we have layer 1, which is the sky on the behind of everything. And then we have clouds. We have clouds again, it's layer 3. And then we have another clouds. And we have huge clouds. And then we have bushes, it's layer 6, and another bushes, which is in layer 7. By the way, it can be renamed to trees because they are not bushes anymore, but that's fine. So we have 7 layers of the background, and as you see, they are all in the same size. So 2048 on 1615. So all of them follow the same size, and this way we can put them on top of each other, and it works. And now we need to add the assets directory in the PowerSpec file. So we have something like this here. And yeah, so we can say assets images and assets images background. Yeah, so let's do a pop get. Okay, now I think we are ready to add the player here. So I'm gonna find the player source code. I think it is here. Yeah, we called it dash and it just draws a rectangle at the moment. And as you see, we are rotating it because in each frame we are adding the angle and it makes the rotation effect. Let's create a component directory to make it cleaner. So we can copy paste the dash inside the component. I'm gonna create a file called dash.dart and I'm gonna import the components and canvas and basic palette. And here we just adding the import. And yeah, so I think we are ready to go. Yeah, so let's remove this one, the other rectangle that we have. And now we have only the dash. So let's remove the rotation effect. And now we can add the dash image into the component that we have. To do that, we are gonna have a sprite here. So it's like dash sprite. So basically a sprite is like an image. So it's a region of an image that can be rendered in the canvas. And for example, in this case, it's gonna be the whole image because we only have one element inside the image. So for example, in some cases we have a sprite sheet. And yeah, for example, in this case, each part of the design can be a sprite. So for example, you can have animation that you show different parts of the sprite sheet to animate the player. And yeah, so because we are not gonna have a sprite sheet, we just have a single image, we are gonna use a sprite for the whole image that we have. So we are gonna add the sprite here in the dash and it's gonna be a late variable and we are gonna say dash sprite is sprite.load. And in the load method, we need to pass the src, which is the source file of the sprite. So we are gonna say dash.png. And because it is inside the assets slash images, Flame knows where to load it. So you just need to write dash.png. And I think we need to add an await here and we need to make the, we are in update. Sorry, we need to do it in the onload. Yeah, and it's gonna be a future and here we can have async and we are gonna add super.unload. Yeah, it's gonna be future of void, I believe. And so now we have the sprite. By the way, in the load constructor, you see that you can tell the src position, src size, and the other parameter, which is images that I'm not sure about it. But yeah, the point is that you can specify which part of the image should be loaded. But when you don't specify anything, it loads all the image. So because we only have one player inside the image, that's fine. And then we can render it inside the canvas. So there is a render and we can say render it in the canvas. And then, yeah, so let's see what happens when we render it. Okay, so it's very large. So we need to override the size here. So size should be the size of the player that we have. And yeah, okay, so there's a problem here with the anchor that we have. First of all, let's set the anchor to center because we need to grab the player from the center point and it's gonna be anchor.center. And now I'm not sure which position is correct because the rectangle is here, but the player is here. To realize where is the exact bounding box of the player, there's an option to turn on the debug mode. So there's a debug mode and you can set it to true. And if you run again, you see that there is a box that is the player is allowed to render itself. So, or it is the bounding box of the component. And yeah, so you see that the red rectangle is drawn offset of the area that is allowed to render. And so we are gonna remove it. And yeah, so this is our player. And as you see here, we have a plus icon, which is the anchor point of the player. And it is correct, it is zero. And as you remember, our player position is zero. So it means that here in the middle of the screen and the top left point is minus 20 on X and minus 20 on Y. And the bottom right is 20 and 20. So because the size is 40 and it's like minus 20 and plus 20. So let's increase the size. By the way, we can use vector2.all to set both values at the same time, and we're gonna use 80 maybe. Yeah, I think it's better. And now we can remove the debug mode because we are pretty sure that we are drawing the image inside the box that is assigned to the component. And yeah, okay, so we have the player, and now for example we can change the position. We can increase it by vector 2 of 10 and 0 maybe, or 1 and 0, and you see that it goes on the right side. And if you set minus 1, it goes back, or maybe minus 11. Yeah, so now we are able to move the player inside the screen. And okay, so now I'm gonna introduce you a new component, which is a sprite component. So suppose that we have dash 2, which extends a sprite component. The sprite component extends the position component and it draws the sprite under the hood. So you don't need to load the sprite and render it. It just does this under the hood, and you just need to add the constructor. And inside that, for example, add the super.sprite and make it required. So this way you are gonna have the sprite under the hood. So you just need to load the sprite and pass it to the sprite component, and it renders the sprite. But for now, let's continue with the customized one that we have. So we have a control over the sprite that we are rendering. And now let's talk about the parallax effect. So as you remember, we have the background here. So yeah, the background has some layers and we already imported it here. And now we need to add the background to the game. So to do that, I'm gonna talk about the parallax component. Yeah, it's here. So as you remember in the first episode or second episode, I explained about the parallax component. So with this effect, you can have layered of your background, and they move with different speed based on the distance that they have to the player. So for example, here, let's add this one in the Flappy Dash game. Before we add the dash, we just need to load the parallax component. And load parallax component. What is this? Okay, so it seems we need to extend the parallax component. So let me grab this code. I'm gonna create the dash back ground, and here we have Flappy Dash game, and here we can say game maybe load parallax, and inside that we need to add the layers that we have. For example, layer 1, layer 2, clouds. Okay, so we have loaded all the sprites here using the load parallax, and By the way, it loads something called Parallax and it contains the layers. So we just need to pass the Parallax to the Parallax component that we have and it renders them under the hood. And now we just need to remove these codes and just add the dash background. Yes, so let's hot restart. Okay, so it says that assets, images, layer 1, sky.png doesn't exist. Oh, I got the point. As you see, it is trying to load the layer 1 sky from the assets slash images, but we have them inside the background. So we need to add background slash here before them. Okay, so as you see, we just added the background parallax and the point is that the anchor is top left. Maybe we can change the anchor to center and load it again. Yeah, so we have the background drawn on top of each other. So all the layers are working correctly, but the point is that we have some properties here. As you see, let me open it here. We have base velocity and velocity multiplier delta. So at first, let me add the base velocity. It's gonna be a vector 2 which contains x and y. So I'm gonna say that move it on the right by 1 and 0 on the vertical side. So the y-axis should be the same. And also there's another parameter that is velocity multiplier delta. So I'm gonna say 4 for x, 0 for y, and if I run the game again, you see that it moves very fast. So as you see, it moves with 1 because it uses the base velocity. It is 4 times faster and this one is 4 times faster and this one. And so 4 is a big number. Let's decrease it to something like 2. Yeah, so it feels better. What about 1.5? It's too slow. 1.7. Yeah, so I think it's enough for the background because later we are gonna add the pipes. So pipes should be moved faster and the background should be slower. So I think 1.7 is a good number for the background. And yeah, as you see, this one is moving slowly and after that it is moving. And yeah, so we have some layers and they are moving with the speed that is started by 1 and it multiplies the value by 1.7 for the next layer. And yeah, so let's create a component for it. Let's call it dash background or dash parallax background dot dart. And let's move the code inside the dash parallax background. Okay, so let's rename it to dash parallax background. And here we need to import it, dash parallax background. And yeah, so let's run it again. Yeah, as you see, we have the player and we have the background and everything is good. So I think it is enough for this video. And in the next episode, we are gonna implement the jump behavior of the player. So we are gonna add gravity that pulls down the player and we are gonna add an event like tap or pressing on the space if you are on PC. So the player jumps and then the gravity moves it on the bottom again and then you can jump and so on and so forth. So stay tuned for the next video. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe the channel and you can share it with your friends that they are interested in building games. See you in the next episode. Bye.